And to the best of my knowledge so far, nothing has changed. No banksters have been thrown in jail. No more homes for the homeless have been built. And the police still have the same draconian powers that they've always had. Now, a lot of people in the media and just guys on the street say, well, what do you people in Occupy want? What is it all about? Well, the truth is there's a lot of issues here. Corporate greed is one. Homelessness that I mentioned is another. There's a lot of issues here. Now, whether the Occupy movement stays right here in this square, or whether in time they do force us to leave the square, earlier on we were asked for ideas. One of my ideas is we take some directed protests, pick a protest point, might be the banks, might be a corporation, might be some. He's saying Highway 1, something about Highway 1, might be something to do with City Hall. Take the protests to the banks. Take the protests to City Hall. Find out, and it's not that difficult with the internet now, find out where some of the CEOs actually live. Go to the street they live on, not on their own front lawn, because that's private property and you can't do that. But take the protests to the sidewalk, outside the streets of some of the bankers and the CEOs. Because unless we can inconvenience the elite, then we've got no leverage. They're going to look down from their towers, especially in some of the colder cities in Canada, and go, yeah guys, check out the Canadian winter. And they're going to laugh. I believe that we have to inconvenience the elite. Now, I'm not talking about smashing windows and burning buildings down. But we have to at least inconvenience them so that they think about us and so it affects their life the way their decisions affect the lives of everybody here. If we're just hanging around in tents here, it's not going to force any change. So my idea there is take the protest to them. And that's all I wanted to say for now. Thanks.